This video will guide you on how to install a new gas cylinder and perform a diagnostic test on the Micromeritics 3-Flex Surface Characterization Analyzer. Remember to always consult your operator's manual for more detailed information. Please consult with your environment, health, and safety officer for safety and handling requirements for compressed gas cylinders. This video serves as a guide and does not substitute for the safety training required for handling compressed gas cylinders. Gas cylinders should be installed and secured within 6 feet of the analyzer in a well-ventilated area. Longer distances will increase the difficulty in evaluating ambient gases residing in the tubing. Install the regulator on the cylinder. Now install the gas tubing assembly to the regulator. An isolation valve is recommended in between if the line is to be split. The other end of the gas tubing assembly is connected to the rear of the instrument. Note the valve number where the gas was installed. In the 3-Flex Microactive software, go to Unit, Unit Configuration, and type in the mnemonic for the gas. The mnemonic for each gas is designated within their corresponding adsorptive file. If a gas blend is used, update the percentage of the active gas in the blend in the adsorptive file by going to File, Open, Adsorptive Properties. Open the corresponding adsorptive file and update the active gas concentration as listed on the certificate of analysis located on the gas cylinder. Note that the mnemonic for this example is labeled as COHE. There is a built-in diagnostic test to clean and perform a leak check on a new gas connection. Manual operations are required and users will be prompted by the instrument with on-screen instructions. In the software, go to Unit, Diagnostics, Start Diagnostics Test. Click Test and select the corresponding gas valve number to perform the test. Enter the operator's initials and check Reports After Test. Click Start to begin. The instrument will prompt a message indicating the gas line valve number under test. Verify that this is correct and that the gas cylinders are connected according to the operator's manual and your facility's safety requirements. Click OK. The second prompt summarizes the diagnostic procedure. You will need to perform a manual leak check, which will be followed by 20 minutes of evacuation and an automatic leak rate check. Click OK. The third prompt will summarize the manual leak check using Snoop or equivalent, tightening the connections and setting the regulator to 15 PSIG. We will perform the leak check now before moving to the next prompt. First, check that all gas lines are connected. Then, open the gas regulator shutoff valve and isolation valve if installed. Keep the regulator control knob in the fully closed position. Turn on the main gas cylinder shutoff valve briefly to pressurize the regulator, then close it once the high pressure gauge can take a reading. The high pressure gauge should read greater than 500 PSIG. Apply Snoop on the connection between the regulator to the gas cylinder. If bubbles appear, tighten the fittings and recheck for leaks. Do not over-tighten the fittings. Set the regulator to 14 to 15 PSIG by slowly opening the regulator control knob until the low pressure gauge reads 15 PSIG. The isolation valve and regulator shutoff valve should still be open. Then check the remaining gas line for leaks. Click OK on the third prompt if there are no leaks. you are prompted to perform a manual rinse of the connections with IPA and wiping the connections dry. Click OK once this is completed. For this prompt, check that the main gas cylinder shutoff valve is still closed and the regulator shutoff valve and isolation valve open. Click OK once this is verified. Empty sample tubes or plugs can be used to plug the ports, and if a P0 tube is installed, it could be left as is. Click OK once completed. You are prompted to return in 30 minutes to close the isolation valve. Click OK to begin automatic testing. After 30 minutes, you will be prompted to close the isolation valve. If no isolation valve is installed, close the regulator shutoff valve. After closing the valve, click OK and return in 15 minutes to complete the testing. The test is now complete. There are three tabs on the report. Check that all three passed. If there are any tabs that failed, correct the leaks indicated on the report and then rerun the test. If all three reports pass, open the main gas cylinder shutoff valve and verify that the regulator shutoff valves are also open. And that completes this demonstration on how to install a new gas cylinder on the Micromeritics 3-Flex Surface Characterization Analyzer. For more information, visit micromeritics.com/learn.